intelligence theorem. Okay, it is generally with respect to power. Intelligence theorem means with respect to power. Okay, so in any circuit, okay, the sum of the power is equal to zero. Algebraic sum of the power equal to zero, or the power that is power delivered and power observed both are same. Okay, so this is the state. Algebraic sum of power delivered and observed. Power delivered and observed. Okay, power delivered and observed. Power delivered is something is equal to power supplied. Okay, observed is always zero. Okay, so or otherwise you can also write this statement in different format. Okay, power delivered or power supplied is equal to power absorbed or dissipated. Because the resistor will absorb, then it will dissipate. Sometime inductor may absorb. Okay, so power delivered or supplied is equal to power absorbed or dissipated. Okay, so when you take the resistance nature, okay, if the element is resistance, irrespective of the direction of current flow, either from left to right or from right to left, always it absorbs the energy. Okay, and it is not storing. Okay, it is absorbing as well as it is dissipating. It absorbs and dissipates the energy. It absorbs and dissipates the energy. Okay, then suppose instead of resistance, if you are having, and again, what will happen to that inductor? It is also absorbing. Okay, so it will absorb. Okay, it will absorb and store the energy. It will absorb and store the energy. Later, it can give energy also. When the supply is not there, it can give back the energy. That is a different scenario. Okay, then next, what is the independent voltage or current source? Okay, independent voltage or current source. If the independent voltage or current source is there, okay, so it may absorb. Okay, it depends on the situation. What is the direction of current and voltage? Okay, so it may deliver or absorb. It may deliver or absorb. Similarly, for dependent source also. Dependent source, okay, let it be current source or voltage source. Again, that also it may deliver or it may absorb. Okay, it depends on the situation. So now with respect to source, okay, and again with respect to resistor, you always knows the current can enter in this direction. Or the current in this direction, no problem. Finally, the power is absorbed and dissipated. Okay, the power is absorbed and dissipated. Okay, dissipated. Okay, as a heat. Okay, heat energy. Okay, whenever you are having independent voltage source, if you are having independent voltage source, okay, you know what is the voltage, okay, because you are having voltage source, but you do not know what is the current, whether the current is really going outside or the current is coming inside, the real current. Okay, after analysis you will get the current. Okay, it all depends on the remaining parameter, because you may be having more than one source. That time you cannot tell whether the current is really going outside or coming inside. But finally, if it is like this, okay, the voltage and current polarity is like this, then this is delivering the energy. Okay, this is delivering the energy. Or otherwise, if the situation is like this, okay, now this is plus minus, but the current is going in the opposite direction. Okay, if it is like this, then it is absorbing the energy. Okay, it is absorbing the energy. Okay, now, and again, this is with respect to voltage source. For current source also, you can write, If you are having current source, that current is going like this, okay? But finally, you will find out the voltage. If the voltage comes like this, because current is already going in the upward, if the voltage finally calculation comes like this, voltage you have to calculate because you are having current, this V you have to calculate. If this is the case, again, this is also delivering. Okay, or otherwise, if it comes in the opposite way, if your current is like this, the actual voltage that comes in the opposite way, if it is like this, that means that particular current source is absorbing the energy. Okay, absorbing the energy. Again, the same thing is applicable to dependent sources. Okay, instead of this symbol, you'll have some other symbol. That's it. Okay, the same is applicable to dependent sources also. Okay, now I will take one simple problem. There will prove that power delivered is equal to power absorbed. Okay. Now we'll take some question to verify the intelligence theorem. Okay, verify intelligence theorem. Now the question is, you are having this format resistance. This is 3 ohm. This is 3 ohm. This is also 3 ohm. Now 9 volt battery is there. Again, you know, all this resistance definitely is going to absorb the power. And again, here no ambiguity, only 1 voltage is there. Okay, you connect it in any way, because if the circuit is having only 1 voltage source, if the rest of the elements are like a passive elements, then definitely that will deliver the power. There is no doubt. Finally, the current will be going in this direction only. Okay, that is a simple idea. But if there are more than one sources, you cannot tell. Okay, after analysis only you can tell. Okay, now again, what is the total current going? Because 3 parallel with 3 is 1.5 plus 3 is 4.5. Now the 2 ampere current will be coming here. So not to disturb here, I will write here solution. Okay, so I have calculated the total current. Okay, if it is 9 volt, the total current will be going. The total current is 2 ampere. Now the 2 ampere current will go like this. And again, this will be distributed 1 ampere and 1 ampere here. Okay. Now I know current across all the branches, and also I can calculate the voltage. Okay, now the voltage here is 3 volt. Here also 3 volt. What is the voltage here? That is 6 volt. Voltage here is 6 volt. And also I know the current here, that is 2 ampere. Okay, now with respect to 9 volt source, what is the power delivered by the 9 volt source? That is VI. Okay, it is simply 9 into 2. Okay, 9 into 2, 18 watt. Okay, so this power is like a delivered, okay, power delivery. Okay, now what is the power absorbed? 1 by 1 you calculate. Okay, then first 3 ohm. Okay, this 3 ohm if you calculate, 6 into 3. Okay, now again, P is equal to V into I, voltage is 6. Current is 2. Okay, 6 into 2 is 12 watt. Okay, the next what is here the power? Again, here 3 volt 1 ampere, 3 into 1, 6 watt. Next to last one, power 3 ohm is equal to 3 into 1, 3 into 1, 3 watt. Okay, this is also 3 watt. Then finally the total is 18 watt. Okay, this all power is like a dissipated or absorbed. Okay, absorbed. Okay, so the power delivery is equal to power absorbed. Power delivery is equal to power absorbed. Okay, that is the simple idea. Okay, now I will take some other problem. Okay, where I will take more than one voltage source, and I will show you the one source will be delivering the power, that other source will be absorbing the power. Okay, now we'll see. Question, two voltage source will be there. Same question I'm going to modify. Intelligence theorem. Okay, intelligence theorem, same question. Here instead of 3 ohms, I'm putting 1 ohm. Now here 3 ohm. Here also 3 ohm. Now I connect one extra battery here. That voltage is 1 volt. Now here voltage is 9 volt. Now what happens? Okay, this is 3 ohm. Okay, now you just try to find out Okay, but somehow you should know the voltage and current across all the branches. Okay, for this, the easiest method is like nodal method. Okay, once if you know the nodal voltage here, again you know the difference here, and you can calculate the current. You know the difference here, you can calculate the current. You know the difference here, or you can go by any other method, branch current method, or any other method. Okay, so now I will apply the nodal. Okay, now this is the only node. The node is Vx. Don't put the node here because here you know the voltage. Okay, there is no point in putting the nodal here. Okay, so only Vx. If you know, then that's enough. If you calculate Vx, everything is over. So once if you apply the nodal, Vx minus 9 divided by 3, and then Vx divided by 3, Vx minus 1 divided by 1 is equal to 0. Then your Vx will be, once if you solve this, your Vx will be 2.4 volt. Your Vx will be 2.4 volt. Now you know what is Vx. If it is 2.4 volt, then what is the current going here? Because 9 minus 2.4 divided by 3, that is the current going here. Okay, what is that current? That current is 2.3 ampere. Now you know what is Vx. Vx is 2.4 minus 1 divided by 1, that is the current going here. Okay, that is 1.4 ampere. Again, this is Vx with respect to ground. This is 3 ohm. Now you know what is Vx, 2.4 divided by 3, that is 0.8. Okay, now you know current across all the branches, and also you know voltages. Or once if you know the current, already resistance is there, you can easily find out the power. Okay, now only this volt battery, this battery is delivering the power because the current is going out of the battery. But here the current is going into the battery. This battery is absorbing the power. So first I'll write this. Okay, power delivered by the battery, P 9 volt is equal to 9 into 2.3. Okay, 9 into 2.3, that is 19.8 volt. Okay, this is like a delivered, I know, because this is the delivered power. Then what is the absorbed power here? P 3 ohm. Once if you know the current and resistance, you can apply this formula also, because I know the current, then 2.3 square into 3 is equal to 14.52 watt. Next, you apply here. Once if you apply P is equal to 3 ohm, and again I square R, okay, 0.8 square into 3, then you are getting 1.92. Then you apply across 1 ohm here. Okay, 1 square into 1.4 is equal to 1.40 watt. Okay, then what is the power here? 1 volt. Okay, because already you are taking it in the category of delivered. Okay, so again, no need to put minus because we are separating the category. Okay, this is like a different category. This is like a delivered upward, and the bottom one is like a absorbed. Okay, once if you take this 1 volt, okay, then what is happening? It's just simply V into I. Okay, so 1 into 1.4, because for battery there can't be any resistance. So you have to multiply the voltage and current. And I think we made a mistake here. Okay, yes, we made a mistake here. Wait. Here, power across the 1 ohm is equal to I square R. So that means 1.4 square. Into 1, that is 1.96. okay, now the power due to the battery that is absorbed, 1 into 1.4 is equal to 1.40 watt. Now you know all the power delivered, and also you know the power absorbed. You just add all these 4 power. Okay, then once if you add everything, finally this will be equal to 19.8 watt. Okay, 19.8 watt, and this is what delivered, and this is absorbed. This is absorbed. Again, intelligence theorem is proved. Okay, intelligence theorem is proved. Okay, now I'll take one more problem with the dependent sources. It is a little bit tough only. Okay, anyway, we'll solve. Just we'll see what happens. Okay, verify intelligence theorem. Question is, three Vx, 4 ohm, 2 ohm 10 ampere. Okay, 2 ix 3 ohm plus minus vx 1 ohm ix. Okay, now this is the problem. Okay, again this is a voltage dependent current source where vx is given here. This is current dependent voltage source where ix is given here. Now you have to proceed from this. First of all, you should know the current and voltage across all the branches. Okay, all the elements. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Problem is there. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Solana. Last one current is 2.2, sir. Yes, 2.3. Last one. Previous one, sir.
Previous one. Erung, sir. Papa. Previous problem, sir.
Yes, sir.
இதுல எது சார் தப்பா இருக்கு? 2.3 வரலீங்களா? 2.2.
எஸ்
2.2வா சார்?
எஸ் சார் 2.2.
2.2 எஸ் சார். பார்த்தது மட்டும் தப்பா இருக்கேன். ஓகே சார். 2.2 இஸ் தி ஆன்சர். 2.2. ஓகே சார். ஓகே சோ இன் திஸ் ப்ராப்ளம் ஓகே அகைன் ஃபர்ஸ்ட் ஆஃப் ஆல் யூ ஷட் நோ வாட் இஸ் தி வோல்டேஜ் அண்ட் கரண்ட் அக்ராஸ் ஆல் தி எலிமெண்ட். ஓகே. Even though this is the current, you should know what is the voltage here. Even though this is the voltage, you should know what is the current here. Current here flowing in this branch. And similarly, here also you should know both the voltage and current. Again, this is the current source, but you need the voltage also. What is the voltage across this current source? Then only you can apply the intelligence theorem. Okay. Now, I will modify in this diagram with a different color. Okay. How to proceed this? Okay, somewhere we have to start. Okay, so this is ix, this is 2 ix. Okay, now 3 vx is coming. It will come in this way and then it will enter in this way. Now this is 3 vx. Okay, now this is 3 vx. Once if 3 vx is coming, ix is going out, then what should be the current here? That is 3 vx minus ix. Okay, because 3 vx is entering, ix is leaving. That means the current going out of this node is 3 vx minus ix. Next, 10 ampere is coming inside. 3 vx minus ix is also coming inside. Then what is the current going out of this node? That is 3 vx minus ix plus 10. Okay, again the same current will reach here. Out of this, that 3 vx will go away. Or otherwise you can also solve in some different way. The ix is coming here. That means here also ix. Ix is entering, but 10 ampere is leaving. That means current across, current through this branch is ix minus 10. Or otherwise, even if you come this way, you will get minus ix plus 10. Both are okay, because once if you try to come from this way, this 3x will go up because this is 3 vx. That means this also 3 vx current, but remaining thing is minus ix plus 10. Then that will come in this way. Both are okay because that is in opposite direction. That's it. Okay, now somehow we know the current across all the branches. Now you apply either KVL or KCL or something. Finally, that Vx and Ix is variable. You have to find out that value. Once if you know that value, then you can calculate the rest of the values. Okay. So I'm going to apply KVL. I cannot apply the KVL in the first loop because here I do not know what is the voltage here. I cannot directly take this voltage here because here one more element is there. Okay, and again I cannot apply the KVL here because I do not know what is the voltage here. Okay, I know the voltage here, but I do not know what is the voltage here. That means I cannot apply the KVL, but I can apply the KVL in this loop. Okay, in this loop I can apply the KVL. Now I will apply the KVL in this loop. Okay, yes. Okay, now I'll apply. Wow. Okay, minus. Okay, I will go this way. Okay, in the clockwise, minus ix. Okay, minus ix plus 6 vx minus 2 ix. Okay, plus 6 vx minus 2 ix. Okay, then minus 2 ix. Then I am coming this way. I am observing the voltage source. That means plus 2ix. Then here, what is the voltage? Already they clearly given the voltage here is Vx. Okay, now Vx is equal to 0. Once if you modify this equation, I think finally you'll get 7Vx minus Ix is equal to 0 once if you make the adjustment. Then somehow I have to make one more relationship. Okay, one more relationship. Don't apply KCL and all here, because by applying the KCL only we got these equations. Okay. Again, don't apply the KCL here, because after applying the KCL only we are getting this equation. Now try to apply something new. Okay, so here I know Vx is my voltage. Here some resistance is there. Once if I know the voltage and resistance across the resistor, then definitely the current is going to be Vx divided by 3. Okay, now this current is coming this way and this is coming, both are in opposite direction. That's why what I can write, Ix minus 10 is equal to minus divided by 3. Both are in opposite direction. If they are in the same opposite direction, that minus will come here. Okay, now again, once if you modify this equation, you will get Vx plus 3Ix is equal to 30. Okay, already you have the equation number 1, equation number 2, just you solve these two equations. Now you will get both Vx and Ix. Vx value is 15 divided by 11 volt. Okay, then Ix value is 105 divided by 11 ampere. Once if you solve this, you will get these two value. Now the problem is almost 50% of the problem is over. Okay, then rest of the things what I have to calculate. And again, in some places, once if Vx, easily apply I square R formula here problem. Here if I know Vx and Ix, I square R formula. Again, here I have to calculate the, really I have to calculate the current, because I cannot apply I square R here. I should know what is this value, current value, and also this voltage value. Similarly, I should know what is the voltage value here. Then only I can complete the problem. Okay, now I will go by, I will go one by one. First we'll find out, first we'll sort out the problem with the resistors, because resistors will always absorb the energy. Okay, irrespective of anything else, always it will absorb the energy. Now we'll concentrate on the resistance. Okay, now 4 ohm resistance. That means what is the current flowing through the 4 ohm resistance? That is 3Vx. Okay, now what is the power across that? Okay, now the power across the 4 ohm resistance is equal to 3Vx whole square into 4 ohm. Okay, because 3Vx is the current here. Okay, and 4 ohm is the resistance. Current means I have to square. Okay, now you know what is Vx, you just find out what is the value. You substitute Vx value, finally you find out what is the power. Okay, the next, what is the resistance due to other, what is the other value? Okay, now what is the resistance due to this? Okay, 1 ohm, I square into R, Ix square into 1 ohm. Okay, so the next one, for 1 ohm, power is equal to Ix square into 1 ohm. Again, you calculate, you know Ix, okay? Then similarly, what is the power for 2 ohm? Okay, where is the 2 ohm? Okay, 2 ohm is here. Okay, 2 ohm is here. What is the power for this? Because I know the current, okay, I know the resistance. Then I can apply the I square R, okay? So 3Vx, now the power across 2 ohm is 3Vx minus Ix whole square into 2 ohm, because you know already Vx Ix value, you can plug in here, then you can find out the power. And what is the power across the 3 ohm? Okay, power across 3 ohm, where is the 3 ohm? The 3 ohm is here. Okay. Now you know what is the current, because Vx is the voltage, but Vx by 3 is the current. Okay, so you can apply Vx by 3 whole square, okay, whole square into that resistance is 3 ohm. Now we have calculated what is the power absorbed by all the resistance. Once if you calculate this value and add all the values, now you will get the power absorbed by all the resistance. Next, we have to concentrate on the source. Okay, one independent source is there and two dependent sources there. Okay, really now we have to concentrate the power is dissipated or absorbed by the sources. For that, you have to do the little bit work out. Now, once I will concentrate on the 3Vx, okay, I do not know whether it is really absorbing the energy or delivering the energy. So, without knowing anything like this, finally I am going to calculate the voltage. across, because this 3 Vx is not the voltage, it is the current. But finally, I want to calculate the voltage across 3 Vx. In which direction it is? Just I am putting plus here, minus here. If my answer is positive, really it is delivering the power. If my answer is negative, okay, that means what? It will absorb the power. That is the concept. Okay. Now I put in this way. Now I am going to calculate the voltage across this one, so I can apply KVL in this loop. Okay, I can apply the KVL. Okay, that means what? Minus of voltage across 3 Vx plus, okay, plus 3 Vx into 4 and again 2 into 3 Vx minus Ix. Okay, then this voltage I know, because here this is the voltage, plus 2 Ix is equal to 0. Once if I use that formula, I will write that formula here. Okay, see, I am going to find out, okay, I'll write in the different color. I'm going to find out the first I'll find out the voltage across this one. So that voltage is minus 3 Vx, minus 3 Vx, okay, plus 3 Vx into 4 plus 6 Vx minus 2 Ix plus 2 Ix is equal to 0. So finally V3 Vx is equal to 18 Vx. You know what is Vx. You can calculate again. Vx is not negative. Vx is positive. Then this is also positive. That means finally, what is the power? Power is equal to 18 Vx, okay, because Vx is the voltage. Okay. Then what is the current going here? Current going here is 3 Vx. Okay. So 18 Vx, 3 Vx. Once if you calculate this, then that will become a positive. Then definitely this is delivering the power. Okay, this is the power delivery, but all these are like a absorption. They are absorbing. Okay, but this 3 Vx is delivering the power, and then we have to really see the other natures. Okay, other. Next, I will take this 10 ampere. Okay, what happens? Okay, next to 10 ampere. Once if it is 10 ampere, and then you just try to find out, try to find out the, here this is current I know, that means I find out the voltage here. Okay, so that means what? I can apply the KVL here, because I know this voltage, then I can easily find out this voltage, or otherwise I can also apply the KVL here. Okay, so but once if you apply here, it is a little bit easy, because voltage across this one, if you take in this manner, okay, again here also I do not know what is going to happen. Simply I will put plus minus, I will go this way. If this is positive, then this is delivering the power. If my answer is negative, then this is absorbing the power. Okay, so minus V 10 ampere is plus 2 Ix plus Vx. Okay, that is the equation. Okay, I'll write it here. So minus V 10 ampere, that means voltage across 10 ampere, plus 2 Ix plus Vx is equal to 0. So V 10 ampere is equal to 2 Ix plus Vx. You know what is Ix, Vx. Okay, then what is the power across 10 ampere? That is 2 Ix plus Vx into 10 into 10. So I know Ix is positive, Vx is also positive. Definitely this will be positive. That means this is delivering the power. Okay, this is power delivery. Next we'll concentrate about the final component, that is final. Okay, voltage source. So 2 Ix. Okay, then again I should know what is the again, this is the voltage, 2 Ix is the voltage. I should know what is the current here. Okay, because current here is given by this one, but this current is not going out of the source, it is entering into the source. Okay, it is entering into the source. Now I will take as it is. Okay. Now, once if you take as it is, P is equal to 3 Vx minus Ix plus 10, because current is going inside, and then 2 Ix. Okay, so first one is current, the second one is voltage. Now I do not know what is going to happen, because here minus is there. Okay, finally I do not know whether the answer is positive or negative, it could be anything. But you took the current in the direction going inside the battery. If the result is positive, if it is positive, then it is absorbing the energy. Okay, if it is positive, you have to add in the absorbing category. Yes, because you took the current direction in such a way. Okay, if it is positive, you have to take it in the category of absorbing. or if it is negative, then it is delivering the power. Okay, it is delivering the power. Okay, we do not know now. We cannot give any assurance here. Okay, so you have to really calculate whether final value is positive or negative, then only you can conclude. Okay, so and finally, once if you add the power delivery is equal to power absorbed. Okay, but please try to do it. Okay, it will take more than half an hour if you do it yourself. Okay, please practice it. Okay, finally try to prove. Okay, yes, sir, you got some understanding about Telegen's theorem, how it is getting operated with the dependent sources? Yes, please somebody tell me. Purida or alloge?
Sir.
Yes, yes sir, solunga.
The current direction, eppadi sir, edho vechirukinga?
Eppadi onnal edukalam sir. Edho onnal edukalam. Final positive one month. You can take it, all comes by practice, or by practice only. Practice panna da eduk mudiyum eppadi onnal edukalam, edhum rule la kedaiyadhu. Na inga irundhu start panna indha current eppadi varudhu ovana appadi porom avladhaan. Okay, neenga vera engana irundhu kuda start pannalam, eppadi onnalum pannalam, edho oru point la start pannanum, edhu pannanum, adha eppadi onnalum polam. Neenga indha method illama vera edhana method kuda apply pannalam. Na vandhu branch current method apply pannirukken, neenga nodal kuda apply pannalam. So in the point la nodal, but nodal apply panumbodhu some problems la varum indha edathula, adanal na nodal pola. Ena nodal apply panumbodhu current inga ungalku therinjidudhu, sometime voltage mattum dhaan irukum, ipo inga enna panuvinga current edathukala kashtama irukum. So adanal nodal pola, just branch current method vechi KVL vechi porom, edhum hard and fast rule la illa. By practice only you can get this, what okay, endha direction la edukrom, edhum rules la kedaiyadhu IX ana, but avanga kuduthirukiradha nama maatha koodadhu. எப்பவுமே இந்த ஐஎக்ஸ் நான் இதெல்லாம் டச் பண்ணவே இல்லை பாருங்க, இதெல்லாம் அவங்களே கொடுத்தது, அந்த பிளாக் கலர்ல கொடுத்ததுல அவங்களே கொடுத்தது. அதை நம்ம எந்த மாடிஃபிகேஷனும் பண்ணக்கூடாது அந்த வேரியபிள்ல, ஏன்னா அதை மாடிஃபை பண்ணா டிபெண்டன்ட் சோர்சஸ் உடைய எஃபெக்டே போயிடும். ஓகே, அதை மாடிஃபை பண்ணக்கூடாது. மற்றதெல்லாம் நீங்க எப்படி ஒன்றாலும் எடுத்துக்கலாம், ஜஸ்ட் கேவிஎல் கேசிஎல், இட்ஸ் ஆல் கம்ஸ் பை பிராக்டிஸ். ஓகே சார், எஸ் ஐ வில் நெக்ஸ்ட் ஐ வில் கோ டு தி மில்லிமென்ஸ் தியரம். Okay, next put the elements down. Okay, so the Millman's theorem gives the idea about if you are having a practical generators, okay, practical voltage generator, if they are connected in parallel, then what is the equivalent value? Okay, that idea is given by the Millman's theorem. Say for example, practical generator means practical voltage source. Okay, one generator is developing the voltage with the internal resistance R1, and another generator is developing R2. Okay, then one more generator, you can connect any number of generator you want. Okay, that voltage is V3, here it is V2. Okay, now it is generating the power, finally it is connected to some load, that's okay. Some load is there. Equivalently, how can you represent with help of only one resistance and only one voltage source? This is somewhat similar to what, sir? Similar to which theorem? Already we have seen this. When you finally represent with respect to one voltage and one source, that is similar to what?
Thevenin's.
Yes, Thevenin's theorem. So that's why before going into the Millman's theorem, I will start with the Thevenin's theorem. Okay, later how to apply the Millman's theorem. Again, Millman, whenever Millman's theorem is there, make sure that there is no extra element in the pot. Okay, it has to be in this manner only, the structure. Or otherwise, once if you apply the source transformation, then the structure has to be like this. Okay, more or less. Okay, now you can apply the Thevenin's theorem. If this is R dash, this is V dash. From the experience, you know R dash is something similar to R Thevenin. V dash is something similar to V Thevenin. We know the Thevenin method. Okay, but here Millman theorem is giving some simple idea. Okay, whenever the structure is like this, but I will okay, I will start with again we can go by Thevenin's theorem also, or otherwise I will apply the ordinary procedure. Okay, like nodal equation and all, I will apply, then we will see okay how to find out this V dash and R dash. Again, finding out that R dash is very very simple, because you are going to short the voltage sources, you are going to remove the effect of the voltage sources. So once if you remove the effect of voltage sources, R dash is something something like R1 in parallel with R2 in parallel with R3, okay, in parallel with R3. Okay, now and again you know this 1 by R dash is equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2. This you know already, okay, because when the resistance are in parallel, again how to calculate this R dash. But the next, how to calculate that B dash? Okay, for that you can apply the Thevenin's theorem also. How to find out the open circuit voltage? Okay, for that again, to calculate the open circuit voltage, you can apply any method, mesh equation or nodal equation or branch current method. You can apply any equation. Now I am going to apply the nodal equation. Okay, to calculate this V Thevenin, I am going to apply nodal equation. Okay, this is the open circuit voltage. This we are calling it as a Thevenin voltage plus minus V Thevenin. If it is V Thevenin, this is also V Thevenin. This is also V Thevenin. This is also V Thevenin. All are V Thevenin only because all are same point. Okay. And now one more confusion is there here. And again, some time